We'll move on to the second talk, which will be, I think, given by CLD from University of Southern California on semantic segmentation with perverse attention.
But with this kind of only for architecture only. We are going to need slightly better performance because actually those two branches are identical in terms of the architecture. So there are still some confusion suffering here. To further enhance this reverse region of the objects, we decided to add some nonlinear attention map over here. So we have a reverse attention module. And this reverse attention module will be multiplied with the negative response and finally subtracted from the original branch. So this is a more detailed look at the whole network. So during the implementation for the reverse branch, we actually get this feature map and do the negation. So it can be trained with the original branch root labels. And for this attention branch, we first also negate the feature response and then use the sigmoid to normalize it to 0 to 1. And so this attention map will be used as the weight parameters to this negative response. And then finally, there's a subtraction. So I will talk a little bit detail about the attention branch here. The one I presented here is illustrated by this formula that this is the simple reverse attention calculation. So it's very straightforward that we negate the response and apply sigmoid. From this simple attention calculation, we also propose another computation mechanism where we call the reverse attention a normalized version. So for this formula, we just take a value to keep the positive part only and normalize it to minus 4 to 4, which means we cover most of the range of the sigmoid function. So to compare those two computations, actually if you take the derivative, you will find that the derivative will be larger for the normalized version if the feature response is small. So which means during the training, the normalized version will give faster convergence. And here is the details about the whole thing, how do we do the training and inference. So the black paths, the black lines indicate the inference path, and backward path is represented by the red ones. Basically, we train the three branches together. So the branch root will be used to train the reverse branch, the original branch, together directly, and also be trained with the combined branch. And during the inference, we take the output from the combined branch only. And here are some visualization of the final response for every category. So if you compare this original response with the combined response, you can find that actually this region where the confusion is likely to happen. Actually, both responses for both categories are suppressed, but we find that the suppression for the cat is more, so which means we can get more pixels to be dog and get things more right here. And we actually tried this kind of reverse attention network on different kinds of data sets. I believe most of them are commonly used for evaluation. So including Pascal VLC, Pascal Context, and NYU Depth. So we here to select some examples from the Pascal Context data set, which is very challenging. So if you look at the last block, the last two lines are our results. And if we compare with our baseline architecture, which is essentially the deep lab V2 based on ResNet, so we managed to get about 4.5 gain in terms of the IOU evaluation. And we also managed to get higher performance than the RefineNet, which is based on a deeper ResNet. And here are some visual examples. So this one is quite challenging because the hair of the person is a little bit like some animal feathers, and the baseline we compare with the ground truth. And also for this first example, the baseline gets kind of messy at the ground, but we managed to clean it up. And also we did some ablation study. So the second line will be the two branches with the reverse attention, with the reverse branch and the original branch only. So we also follow the ablation study setting proposed in Deep Pathway 2. So basically, the reverse attention gives higher performance on every training setting, and the simple attention computation and normalized attention computation gives very similar results. But as I mentioned before, actually the normalized version will give higher derivative, which means faster training. So to wrap things up, first of all, we actually observe some confusion, which is from the similar textures from different categories. And the solution we propose to solve this problem is to specifically understand what does not belong to any class. So that's why we propose the reverse branch. And then we try to add more nonlinearity to this whole system. So we have this reverse attention map that which tries to enhance the area where the confusion is likely to happen. And finally, we propose the end-to-end training system. So, and we managed to get state-of-the-art performance on five different data sets. So that's all. And I'm sorry that the poster was on Tuesday. So if you are interested in more details, you can look at the paper. The ID is 86. Thanks.
Okay, thanks very much for the useful method. So do we have questions on this? I guess I should say I appreciate the results from Pascal context, because we constructed this and I know it's a really